Welcome, dear friends. The order today is order Hymenoptera, where the meaning of hymen is membrane and tera means the wings. So it becomes Hymenoptera. Or second definition or description is hymeno, that is god of marriage, and tera means wings. So Hymenoptera depicts god of marriage, and the meaning again there given as marriage on the wings, or union of fore and hind wings by hamulli is the wing coupling apparatus of these members of Hymenoptera. Then the common names of the members of this order: ichneumon flies, the ants, bees, and wasps. Now the characteristics. First is the mouth parts are primarily adapted for chewing. The mouth parts are chewing type. The mandibles are very well developed. In case of bees, the labium and maxillae are integrated to form the lapping tongue. As you can see, in case of many of these hymenopterans, they are capable of collecting the nectar for their feeding, so they are having a lapping tongue. Then second is the thorax is modified for efficient flight. Thorax is modified for efficient flight. The pronotum is collar like. Pronotum is the first thoracic segment and its tergum. So the first thoracic segment, that is the prothorax, bearing the tergum, and that tergum is collar like. The mesothorax is enlarged, metathorax is small. Both prothorax and metathorax are fused with the mesothorax. This is a common thing that we know, that the prothorax is the first one and mesothorax is the second one and metathorax is the third one, means pro, meso, and meta. So the prothorax will be attached with the mesothorax and metathorax will be attached with the mesothorax. Then the wings are stiff and membranous. Fore wings are larger than the hind wings, and also here in the earlier point there is a description that the mesothorax is enlarged. So for good flight, the mesothorax is having the fore wings which are larger. Again, the wing venation is reduced. Both fore wings and hind wings are coupled by rows of hooklets called as hamulli, and they are present on the leading edge of the hind wing. Leading edge of the hind wing means on the anterior side, towards the head side of the hind wing. You may say the costal margin is having the hamulli. Then abdomen is basally constricted. The first abdominal segment is called as propodium. The first abdominal segment of order Hymenoptera is called as propodium. It is fused with the metathorax. First abdominal segment of Hymenopterans is fused with the metathorax, means the last thoracic segment. The first pair of abdominal spiracles is located in the propodium. First pair of abdominal spiracles located in the propodium. As we have seen earlier in the respiratory system, the abdomen is bearing the spiracles. Again, the second segment is known as the pedicel. Second segment of thorax, of abdomen is pedicel, which connects the thorax and the abdomen. So propodium is the first abdominal segment, then pedicel is the second abdominal segment, and beyond that the remaining part of abdomen The abdomen beyond the pedicel is called gaster or metasoma. Gaster or metasoma. So the abdomen is having the first segment called as propodium, the second segment called as pedicel, and the third segment or the remaining segments, they are called as gaster. So propodium, pedicel, and gaster or metasoma. The ovipositor is always present in the females. It is variously modified for oviposition or stinging or sawing or piercing plant tissues. So they are laying their eggs. What the type and style of laying the eggs is, you can understand regarding this, that their ovipositor is modified as a sting, or they can saw means cut the surface for laying the eggs, or piercing the plant tissue to lay the eggs. Then the metamorphosis is complete. So it is endopterygote, you may say. It is having indirect metamorphosis, you can say. It is complete metamorphosis with four stages: the egg, larva, pupa, and adult. But here the larva is called as grub. So often the grub is apodous and eucephalous. Apodous, it is not having the legs, and eucephalous, head is developed one. Then the larva is rarely erusiform, means it is not like the larvae of caterpillars, or you may say the lepidopterans, where they are erusiform or cylinder like body. Then the pupa is exarate, means its appendages, they will be seen attached. Its appendages will be seen not attached to the main body of the pupa, and frequently enclosed in a silken cocoon secreted from the labial glands. The sex is determined by the fertilization of the eggs, whether the egg is fertilized or not. It defines how actually the young one is to be produced, whether it is a male or female. Okay, so if the egg is fertilized, then it will produce the females, and if the egg is not fertilized, it is giving out, or from that egg the males hatch out. The males are haploid and females are diploid naturally. That is, it is the egg which is not fertilized, it will have only the you may say the female characters, or you may say that it is produced directly from the mother. But in case of the females, both the sperms and the eggs, they will unite, the embryo will be fertilized one, and it will produce diploids. The chromosome number is doubled. So the classification of this order is done in two suborders. It is divided as Symphyta and Apocryta. Symphyta, you may have the name Chalastogastra, that is Symphyta, and Apocryta is Clistogastra. Symphyta is Chalastogastra and Apocryta is Clistogastra. Then abdomen in Symphyta is broadly joined to the thorax, while in Apocryta the abdomen is petiolated. The larvae is a caterpillar and belongs to erusiform type in Symphyta, and in Apocryta the larva is a grub and belongs to apodous eucephalous type. Then the third point, stemmata are present. What is stemmata? They are the ocelli, you may call them. Earlier we are dealing with the simple eyes. They are the stemmata. The stemmata are present in the Symphyta, and the Apocryta, the stemmata are absent. Fourth point, both thoracic and abdominal legs are present in Symphyta, whereas the legs are absent in Apocryta. In case of Apocryta, they are not having the abdominal legs. So the abdominal legs, they are called as prolegs. Again, ovipositor piercing the plant tissue in Symphyta, it is saw-like. It pierces the plant tissue and lays its eggs. Whereas in Apocryta, that is Lystogastra, the ovipositor is not saw-like and is suited for piercing in parasitic groups or for stinging in other groups. So meanwhile, you can see the simple classification that will lead to your basic understanding that the members of Symphyta, they will be having their activity or feeding on the plants. And in case of Apocryta, this is just a crude one I'm saying for your understanding. In case of Apocryta, it is having piercing type of ovipositor where it can lay the eggs in the body of the members or its prey. So Apocryta will have the stinging or piercing type of ovipositor. Then in Symphyta, the behavioral sophistication is less. Behavioral sophistication is less, means they may not show that much of preciseness in their behavior of feeding and other activities. But in case of this second one, that is Apocryta, the behavioral sophistication is more. You may see much of the planning, much of the intelligence in them. Then in Symphyta, they are phytophagous. The basic difference, Symphyta is phytophagous. Symphyta is Chalastogastra. It is phytophagous, feeding on plants, and they turn out to be your pests in the crops if they are feeding on the crops. And in Apocryta, that is Clistogastra, somewhat tongue twister, they are generally parasitic. So you can get the idea of these two suborders through this chart. Then suborder Symphyta, we'll have it fast now. The names of the families and what are the characters, we have taken all the characters earlier, so not needed to be much going deep into that. Suborder Symphyta, first family, 10th Radinidae. We have the sawflies from this family, 10th Radinidae, sawflies, 10th Radinidae. Then they are the wasp insects. The abdomen is broadly joined to the thorax. We have seen earlier in the defining or the distinguishing points under Symphyta. Then the ovipositor is sawtooth and suited for slicing the plant tissue for laying the eggs. The larvae is erusiform and it resembles a Lepidopteran caterpillar, and it has one pair of ocelli, one pair of simple eyes, papillae, the reduced antenna, three pairs of thoracic legs, and on the abdomen it will have 6 to 8 pairs of abdominal legs. So this will lead to show or just present that larva just like the sawtooth. Okay, as we can see, whole of the body from the thorax till the abdominal last segment, it will have legs and legs only. So as the appearance of a saw is for cutting the wood, the same type of appearance you can see in case of the larvae of these 10th Radinidae, that is the sawflies. So hence they are called as sawflies. That appearance makes them sawflies of having 6 to 8 pairs of abdominal legs. Then the prolegs, they are lacking the crockets. On the right side you can see the mustard sawfly. The prolegs, they are not having the crockets. They are external feeders on foliage. They cut the foliage and feed on it. The larvae while feeding usually have posterior part of the body coiled over the edge of the leaf. It is having its body coiled. The mustard sawfly, this is Attalias lugens proxima. It is defoliator of mustard and cruciferous vegetables. So this one here, mustard sawfly adult is there, and it is going to lay the eggs on the mustard plant or the group of crucifers. Then now we'll see the suborder Apocryta. This one is the only pest that we can see or know in case of Symphyta. Now the suborder Apocryta, here The first family is Ichneumonidae. The ichneumon flies. The adults are diurnal and visit the flowers. So generally the hymenopterans, they are diurnal, means they are active during the daytime and doing their work. Second point is the trochanter is two segmented. What is trochanter? It is present in the leg, the second segment of the leg after the coxa, attached to the coxa, and on the distal end it is attached to the femur. So the trochanter is two segmented. Hind femur is with trochanterus. Then forewing has two recurrent veins. Petiole is curved and expanded at the apex. Petiole is the second abdominal segment that you know now. Then sternites of the gaster are membranous. Sternites, the lower segments of abdomen of gaster, is the third segment and beyond segments of the abdomen, they are membranous. The ovipositor is arising anterior to the tip of the abdomen. It is often longer than the body. Ovipositor is, photograph you'll see it, and exerted out permanently, means it is not retractile and it is just left external. You can see the ovipositor always in the same position as it does bear it on its body. Then the larvae are mostly parasites and less frequently hyperparasites. Less frequently means there may be a chance of them being hyperparasites, but they are generally parasites and they are very good biocontrol agents also. They are solitary parasites. Solitary means they are feeding singly. Okay, they are single only, feeding on a single paste only. Then they spin cocoons in or outside the host. Erebus trochanteratus is the exotic larval parasite of coconut blackhead caterpillar. Erebus trochanteratus, exotic larval parasite of coconut black-headed caterpillar. Here you can see how it looks. Ichneumonids. Then the braconids. They are small, stout-bodied insects. They're body stout. Then the forewings are one recurrent vein is present in the wings. Then the petiole is neither curved nor expanded at the apex. The gaster is sessile or subsessile. The sternites of the gaster are partly membranous. The abdomen is a long, is as long as the head and thorax together, means it is much lengthy. Then they parasitize lepidopteran larvae commonly. They are gregarious parasites, means they are feeding in groups. In many species, polyembryony is observed. Polyembryony means multiple embryos from a single egg. You can say that they are emerging out. Then, in these species, the pupation occurs in silken cocoons, either externally on the host or away from the host in groups. Example is given. The Bracon brevicornis is mass multiplied and released for the control of coconut black-headed caterpillar. Then next family is Bethylidae. This is also a parasite. They are ant-like black-colored wasp. Ant-like. You can see in the photograph how they look. They just resemble the ants. And they are black colored wasp. The females of many species are wingless. Females are wingless in many species. Paracerola nephantidis is a specific larval parasite. Paracerola nephantidis against the कोकोनट ब्लैक हेडेड कैटरपिलर फैमिली बेथेलिडी. देन फिफ्थ वन चेल्सी डिडे फैमिली चेल्सी. दे आर स्मॉल टू मीडियम साइज्ड इंसेक्ट्स. हाइंड कॉक्जे आर 5 to 6 टाइम्स लार्जर देन द फोर कॉक्जे. देन हाइंड टीबियल स्पर्स आर लार्जर देन मिड टीबियल स्पर्स. सो द कॉक्जा इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ लेग. देन टीबिया इज द पार्ट ऑफ लेग एंड फीमर इज बिटवीन द ट्रोकेंटर एंड द टीबिया. सो हाइंड फीमोरा दैट इज द फीमर बेनिथ शॉर्ट टीथ बेनिथ मीन्स स्पाइन लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स आर देर. देन द विंग विनेशन इज रिड्यूस्ड टू अ सिंगल एंटीरियर वेन. द ओविपोजिटर इज शॉर्ट एंड स्ट्रेट ओविपोजिटर. एग्जाम्पल ब्रैचिमेरिया स्पेसिस इज अ प्यूपल पैरासाइट ऑन कोकोनट ब्लैक हेडेड कैटरपिलर. ब्रैचिमेरिया स्पेसिस देर में बी अ ब्रैचिमेरिया नेफेंटिडिस अगेंस्ट कोकोनट ब्लैक हेडेड कैटरपिलर. द नेक्स्ट फैमिली इज यूलोफिडे. सो दे आर माइन्यूट प्यूपल पैरासाइट्स. नोट दिस प्यूपल पैरासाइट्स. फोर विंग इज नैरोअर विथ प्यूबेसेंस. प्यूबेसेंस मीन्स द हेयर ऑन द विंग लैमिना. विंग लैमिना देर आर हेयर. हेयर्स आर नॉट अरेंज्ड इन रोज. दे आर जस्ट रैंडम. ओविपोजिटर इज प्रेजेंट ऑलमोस्ट एट द टिप ऑफ द एब्डोमेन. टेट्रास्टिकस इज़राइली इज अ ग्रेगेरियस. ग्रेगेरियस दिस ग्रेगेरियस नाउ इट इज इन ग्रुप्स. द ग्रेगेरियस प्यूपल पैरासाइट कॉमनली यूज फॉर द कंट्रोल ऑफ कोकोनट ब्लैक हेडेड कैटरपिलर टेट्रास्टिक. देन ट्राइकोग्रामेटिडे दिस वन वी आर डीलिंग विथ कंटिन्यूसली बिकॉज इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फैमिली एंड द मेम्बर्स ऑफ ट्राइकोग्रामेटिडे आर यूटिलाइज्ड इन द पेस्ट मैनेजमेंट इन मेनी क्रॉप्स. द पेस्ट आर ऑफ ऑर्डर लेपिडोप्टेरा एंड दिस लेपिडोप्टेरन पेस्ट आर मैनेज्ड बाय दिस मेम्बर द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स ऑफ ट्राइकोग्रामेटिडे. सो दे आर वेरी टाइनी इंसेक्ट्स 0.3 to 1 mm long. Tarsus is 3-segmented. Then forewing is broad with pubescence, that is pubic hair in rows. Hindwing is reduced and fringed with hairs along the margins. Hindwing is reduced and fringed with hair along the margins. They are mainly egg parasites. They are parasitizing the eggs of Lepidopteran insects. They are laying their eggs in or on the eggs or in vicinity of the eggs of the Lepidopteran insects. Then Trichogramma species is extensively used in the biological control of sugarcane moth or sugarcane borers and in many other pests. You can say in cotton also, in maize also. Then so you can see a female of Trichogramma. It is ovipositing or it is parasitizing the egg of some Lepidopteran pest. Then family Avianidae. The members of this family called as ensign wasp. Here the petiole is long and abrupt. Petiole, the second segment, okay, is long. You can see in the photograph. Then the gaster is short. Gaster means third segment and beyond till the last segment of the abdomen. Compressed and attached to the propodium. Propodium is the first abdominal segment in Hymenopteran by the slender petiole. It is carried almost like a flag. Then they are parasitic on the uthic of cockroaches. Members of this family Avianidae or the ensign wasp, they are parasitic on the uthicae of the cockroaches. Then Aguanidae, this is also very important wasp. It is called as the fig wasp from this Aguanid group. bear the wings. The females are having the wings, and they are having a long ovipositor. Females, forelegs and hind legs are stout, and the middle legs, they are slender. Middle leg means the thoracic legs, leg pair are slender, and they live inside fig receptacles. They live inside the fig receptacles and pollinate and fructify, that is not fructify, that is fructify the flowers. This word or this name Blastophagaceans is the very important species without which there won't be any pollination in the edible Smyrna fig. So the fig that we eat, that species is called, or that fig is Smyrna fig, and it is not capable of getting itself pollinated by any means. But from Capri fig, it is receiving the pollen, and those pollen, when they are shed, or the pollination is done through the means of this Blastophagaceans only, and then only the sweet and edible fig we can collect and feed upon. So you can see the Blastophagaceans here inside the fig, the adults. Then the next family Vespidae, these are our organisms that we see in many places, in the house also, in the areas near our house or in the fields also. So one by one we'll see the points. First is the lateral extensions of the pronotum reach the point of insertion of wings and do not form rounded lobes. Abdomen is conical. They construct nest with wasp paper, a substance made from the fragments of chewed wood mixed with saliva. So the wasp paper is prepared by chewing the wood, which is mixed with the saliva. They are either solitary or social wasps. These wasps, they are social or they are living separate. They are generally predaceous on Lepidopteran caterpillars, and they paralyze by the sting. They are paralyzing the caterpillars of Lepidopteran order or Lepidopteran paste, and they store them in the cells of their nest prepared out of clay or some other material do generate. The eggs are suspended by filament from top of the nest, and the cell is sealed. So inside that house or the cell created, these larvae of Lepidoptera, which are paralyzed, they are collected by these wasps. They are carried to the cell, they are inserted inside the cell, and later on the eggs, they are extended or they are just suspended in the cell with the help of a filament. And then that cell, which is containing the larvae of Lepidoptera as the food for the young ones, which will hatch out from the eggs of this wasp, and it is packed or sealed and kept it the way till the adults are emerging out of this cell of the wasp. So the name, you can have the yellow banded wasp, that is Vespa cincta, and it is a bee enemy. Yellow banded wasp, Vespa cincta. Then Spacidae, these are the thread vested wasp or digger wasp or mud daubers. Spacidae, the lateral extension of the pronotum form rounded lobes. They form the rounded lobes on the lateral extensions of pronotum. Then the petiole is slender, means the name itself suggests, the thread vested wasp means thread is very small, so is the petiole, means the second abdominal segment. Then the nests are constructed by using mud or dugout in the ground. They use insects and spiders to have the provisions for their nests. Then eggs are laid on the paralyzed or killed host. Next is family Formicidae, and the members of this family Formicidae are ants. They are common widespread insects that we know. The ants are present in the household also, in the field also. So the antennae are geniculate type in this Formicidae. The wings are present. Mandibles are well developed. Third point, I missed that. Then the wings are present only in sexually mature forms. The other workers, they won't have the wings. The petiole may have one or two spines. Petiole means the second abdomen segment may have one or two spines. Now the description is given. A big point is there. So I will just tell about the social insects. In them, they are having three castes, where there is a queen, which is a fertile female. The males, which are utilized for copulation, but after that they are just left away after the mating or fertilization of that female is done, that queen is fertilized. And the workers, they are doing all the duties in that particular social colony. So the workers are sterile. So let's see, workers are the females, which are sterile, and they form the bulk of the colony. The exchange of food materials between adults and immature insects is common. The adults, they are feeding the immatures till they undergo pupation. After a mating flight, so this mating flight is called as nuptial flight. A queen, which is a fertile female, alone finds a suitable nesting site. When it mates, it will find a nesting site and it will start laying the eggs there. What happens in this? This we are discussing about our ants. Okay, so when the queen of these ants, it is mated, then the wings are broken, or there is an abscission suture in the area of that cutting, or that where the wing breaks near the base and nipped off by the mandibles. Then the egg laying is started after divesting the wings. Usually the queen does not forage for food. It does not roam here and there for food, but this work is done by the workers only. During the initial phase of nest building, it lives entirely on the fat body. Those reserves are present inside the body, and that fat is utilized by this queen, and the products of wing muscle degeneration. So that degeneration provides nutrition to the ant queen. Many species have established symbiotic relationship with homopteran insects. Homopteran insects, they are pests of crops, and these ants, they are having symbiotic relationships, wherein the ants, they are providing logistic service, you may say, for these homopteran pests. They get the honeydew from these homopteran pests, and ants provide logistic services to the pests. They carry those pests from one place to another. Then the family Apidae. In this we have our best friend, you may say, the honeybees. The body is covered with branching or plumose hairs. The mouth parts are chewing and lapping type, and the mandibles are suited for crushing and shaping wax for building the combs. Means they are dumbbell shaped mandibles, which are used for molding the wax, which is released out of the abdominal segments number 4, 5, 6 and 7. So these four pairs of abdominal segments on the lower side, that is the sternum, is releasing, or these wax glands, they are releasing the wax, which is molded and utilized for building the combs. Then the legs are specialized for pollen collection, and these pollen collecting legs, they are called as corbiculate or foragial type of legs. Scopa, that is the pollen basket, is a provision, or you may say the modification on the hind tibia, means the hind legs, they are having these pollen baskets on them, on the hind tibia. Then they are social insects with three castes, as in the case of our ants that we have seen earlier. It have the queen, it is a fertile female which mates with the drones, and the workers are working continuously. The drones are haploid and the workers are diploid. And temporal separation of duties is noticed among the workers. So these Apidae family or these members, what they will do, in general in honeybees, we can say there are their life cycle or life stage completed in 6 weeks. In the adult phase, where in 3 weeks they will do the indoor duties in the comb, honeycomb, and in case of the next 3 weeks, from the fourth week till the sixth week, up till it dies, it will do the external duties of and protecting the comb. Then the Indian honeybee, Apis indica, is a productive insect, as well as they are pollinators too. Here we can say that there are four types of honeybees along with the stingless bee. Okay, Apis dorsata, Apis florea, Apis mellifera, Apis indica, and the stingless Melipona or Trigona iridipennis. Then the 14th family is Megachidae. These are the leaf cutter bees. They are solitary, mandibles are sharp and scissor like. The pollen gathering hairs, winter of the abdomen, winter or lower side, you may say, on the sternal region. They cut circular crescent shaped pieces of leaves of rose, red gram, guava, etc. You might have seen this in the field or in the garden, where they cut the leaves into half pieces, crescent shape, just like the half moon that we generally observe, crescent moon. The cut pieces of leaves are used for preparing leaf lined cells. Their cells are leaf lined, so these pieces, they are fixed inside and they are preparing lined cells. The provision for the brood consists of a mixture of pollen mixed with honey, as like the honeybees, pollen and honey, you call it as the bee bread. Rose leaf cutter bee, Megachile anthracaena, is the example of a paste on rose, red gram, and guava. Megachile anthracaena, it cuts the leaves into half. You can see how it cuts the leaves into such pieces, round pieces. They will cut out from the leaves and they will carry for their cell preparation. Then 15th, Xylocopidae. These are the carpenter bees, and it is much famous because they are having some many explanations or utilizations of these carpenter bees at many places, also in the entertainment industry. Also they are using this name. Then they are large robust bees. The dorsum of the abdomen is bare. This means that the tergum of abdomen is bare, means it is not having the hair. Then the pollen baskets are absent in hind legs, but brushes of hairs are present on the hind legs. Pollen baskets are absent, but brushes of hairs are present on the hind legs. They build nest in the dead logs and in live branches of the plants. They tunnel in all the directions. They do not feed on wood. They are not feeding on the wood. So keep this in mind. They are just boring inside and they are preparing a house for them, and they are not feeding on that wood. The tunnel is partitioned into several cells separated by cemented wood chips. The pollen and nectar are placed in each cell. So this means that they are feeding on the nectar and pollen in each cell together with one egg and along with that they are giving the pollen and nectar to their young ones, which will hatch out of the eggs. The larvae hatch, feed, grow and pupate inside that tunnel in the wood. The adults are not aggressive and do not sting. They visit flowers and take nectar, often by simply biting through the base of the flower instead of sipping from the top. They are going to feed with their style of biting through the base of the flower, and they are collecting that nectar. So this is all about the order Hymenoptera. The names of the families will go reverse. The Psilocopidae, carpenter bees. Then family Megachilidae, leafcutter bees. Apidae, honeybees. Formicidae, ants. Spicidae, thread-waisted wasp, digger wasp, mud dauber. Vespidae, yellow jackets, hornets. Agonidae, fig wasp. Evanidae, that is ensign wasp. Trichogrammatidae, trichogramma. Eulopidae, these are the tetrastelus israeli. Then Chalcidae, Bethylidae, Braconidae, the Braconid wasp, Ichneumonidae, the Ichneumonid or Ichneumon flies in order, suborder Apocryta, and the one in suborder Symphyta is Tenthredinidae. The two suborders Symphyta and Apocryta, Symphyta is Chalastogastra and Apocryta is Clistogastra, and the name of this order is Hymenoptera. It is hymen, that is membrane, or hymeno, that is god of marriage, and te means wings. So thank you very much.